All right, now it's time to give the floor over to four YouTube creators to recap what's going on here behind the scenes. So let's go now to Kyle Bossman, a buddy Boogie, NoClip's Danny O'Dwyer, and YouTube creator Eduardo Beneventui. Go ahead.
Thanks, Jeff. All right, guys, let's talk about the show. We each, I think at this point, like Microsoft's happened, EA's happened.
Yep.
We're knee deep into E3.
Right.
What is your favorite game you've seen so far?
I'll go first?
You go first.
Okay,
let's
talk about my friends over in Poland, said their projects. They finally showed Cyberpunk. I mean, they didn't show gameplay, but they showed the tone of that thing.
And in engine, we got to see it.
Yes,
man. Yes.
And it looks gorgeous. And I think the thing that I was always worried about was that like a Polish studio making like a game based on like Andrzej Sapkowski's book makes sense. Cause it's like, oh, they know that. They know the feel of that, they'll nail it.
Mm-hmm.
Whether or not they can do something in like this super deep, like sci-fi world. Cause it's a genre you can so easily mess up with tropes, but tone wise, it's like, it's cool. Like
yeah.
Every frame, every scene they went to in that trailer looked like, oh, that's dope. Like that lady doing her face and then gonna nail.
Yeah. Yes.
It's like, oh, you guys get this. Like this is, you're gonna nail it.
Can I tell you the moment where I like had a breath of relief was when we just pan over it and it's daylight.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. It's all dark, starts off dark, and then just camera goes poof, daylight.
Right.
It's like, hey, we're good. And that has an attitude. It's kind of fun.
Yes.
Yeah, that was really cool.
I feel like I want to go home and for my YouTube channel just break down that trailer scene for scene because it's just so jam-packed, but
totally.
The games they make are exactly like that. If this is The Witcher 3 in the Cyberpunk universe, then oh my god.
Like the quality of their storytelling has never been, you know, in doubt. So if they're able to do this in like this crazy, it could, in a world that could not be further from the madness of The Witcher 3, right?
Yeah.
This like Dark Ages-esque type of thing.
Mm-hmm.
It's super exciting.
Mm-hmm. Eduardo, what do you think?
Man, Dying Light 2, man. I love Techland. They're amazing people.
Two for two on Polish developers.
Yes, we're staying there.
We'll see if we go four for four. We'll see.
They are amazing people, very passionate about their games. The first Dying Light was amazing. The following for me was an amazing experience to see something that will, you know, improve upon what they built.
Are you one of the half million people still playing?
Not really.
Oh, okay. That's what they said. They said
really?
Like, there's a half million people still playing this game today.
But
yeah.
They update a lot their games.
And I think that's cool,
Me and my wife completed it in co-op about 5 months ago.
Really?
So, and it was out for a long time, so yeah.
No, it's amazing to see that they're giving you multiple choices, you know? You can make decisions, they influence how the world looks and behaves. That's exciting.
That is really exciting. Boogie, what do you think about?
We finally got to see a little bit more Kingdom Hearts 3,
mm-hmm.
and I couldn't be more in love. I played the first Kingdom Hearts when it was brand new, and it brought me back to that moment when you're exploring all of those worlds, and to see the new properties, like even going into the Frozen world, I can't believe, like I still holding on hope that we're gonna go into some Return of the Jedi or maybe, so you know, the Marvel Universe. We haven't seen that, but I'm so excited.
Tomorrow morning, we got the Square Enix scene tomorrow morning. That's when they do Star Wars.
But then Microsoft, I can't get it out of my head. What is Halo Infinite? Halo Infinite, right? And my big concern is I keep going back and forth. This is just another Battle Royale cash-in or is this the original design that Bungie had for Halo, where they wanted to do a giant open world, incredible game.
Oh, you mean like the Mac demos when they like it was like Mac World,
like a strategy game almost. Yeah.
Right? It could be just some incredibly developed world because they showed the animals, they showed the wildlife, they showed the weather effects, and it's only a few seconds long, but that's what's stuck in my head so far, and I can't get it out of my head.
Yeah.
My favorite game, Command & Conquer Rivals. Back to you, Jeff.